Hello folks, and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. I wanted today to pass over to Shu, who does a fantastic YouTube channel, not only diving into Rome, but a range of other things. He talks about digital gardening and loads of other exciting applications that I think you will thoroughly enjoy. He's going to be doing a sort of what's new in Rome. We were chatting a few weeks ago, and I thought it would be a fantastic way to sort of summarize what new features have been added to Rome from someone that actively uses Rome and really is sort of passionate about taking full advantage of the application. So I'm going to pass you over to Shu, and a big thank you for coming on. Please do make sure to subscribe to him.
Hello everyone, my name is Shu. Today I want to talk more about Rome research. A few weeks ago, I was invited as a guest host in this channel to talk about an app called Rome, and Francesco kindly offered me the opportunity to make more videos about Rome. So from now on, every month, I'm going to make a video about what's new in Rome. If you want to learn more about the app, check out my YouTube channel. So the first new feature I really like in Rome is the improved block embed. I use block embed very often, and it now feels much nicer to use. For example, when you want to develop an idea, argument, or hypothesis over time, you can just use block embed and start editing right away without moving to a different page. Also, I discovered that you can embed a page as well. What you have to do is just type the block embed command and the page name inside it. But you can't edit a page, which makes it a little bit less useful. The second new feature is the ability to export the only pages you want to export. Before, you only had an option to export all pages, but now you can select specific pages you want to export. This is useful if you want to share your notes with your friends. You can just go to the All Pages section, tick the pages you want to export, choose the format, and then send it to other people. The third new feature is the Pomodoro Timer. You probably know this already, but it's based on a studying technique called the Pomodoro method, where you focus on 25 minutes and take a break for 5 minutes and repeat the process. It's supposed to improve your productivity, but I don't really use it often, to be honest. Anyways, now you can make a Pomodoro timer by typing /Pomodoro. If you're having trouble focusing, maybe you find this helpful. The fourth new feature is customization with CSS. Before, it was kind of cumbersome to customize your Rome, but now you can easily import other people's themes. All you have to do is to make a page called Rome/CSS and go to the Rome help database, find this page called Rome Code Theme. If you find a theme you want to use, just copy the code and paste it in your Rome CSS page. Finally, now you can easily switch between different databases. So if you have multiple databases like me, you can switch by clicking your name and choose the database you want to go to. This might be useful if you do lots of collaboration with other people, or if you speak multiple languages, you might want to make a database for each language. And being able to switch between databases quickly is very useful. Okay, that's a list of major new updates in Rome. I'm pretty sure there are lots of other improvements, so please feel free to leave a comment about your favorite update. If you'd like to know more about Rome, I have a bunch of videos about it in my channel, so please check it out. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Bye!